much for tuning in today. And today we're going to talk about something a little bit different. Today we're going to talk about planners. This is the time of year that a lot of the planners are out on the market. You get a pretty good selection of what you want. This is the time to grab them. I know some had some sales already. Some of them are going to extend it. And it's also good to watch toward the end of the year when there's a lot of leftover and they go on clearance and you can really get some really good deals. Now, that being said, there are a few planners that you might want to go ahead and consider now while you still have your choice of what you want. And one reason I want to go over planning on my Asperger channel is because executive functioning skills are crucial. And actually, when I talked to my daughter and I said, you know, what do you think is something that's helped you? Because she's been quite successful. She graduated college this year and she's looking at furthering her education. And she thought that it came down to executive functioning skills are really a lot of what helped her to do all this. So a planner helps with that, at least in my opinion it does. It helps us think about what it is that we need to do, and then we write it down, and then we can kind of keep referring to it and keep ourselves on track. Now, there's two kinds of planners that we're going to talk about today, and just to know there's tons, tons out there, tons of ways to do this. There's no right way, there's no wrong way. It's really what you want to do with it. From my personal experience, for the past couple years, I've used a passion planner, and this year I'm switching over to Erin Condren. I did a video on my other channel as to why I did that, and I have to apologize ahead of time. My tripod bit the dust when I was working with it yesterday, so it's a little bit shaky, so hopefully today will be a little bit better. But I'm going to show you both, and then I'm going to give you some suggestions as to a few things to think about to see what might fit you. And even if you don't go with either of these, and I'm not sponsored by any of them, guys, maybe it'll help you know what to look for when you go look for a planner, or even to see if they're even right for you. I will say the Passion Planner has changed a little bit. They only offer one size now, and they have a limited amount of colors that they're offering for 2019. Erin Condren has a heck of a lot to choose from. There's different styles, different layouts. We're going to get into all that. But what I chose for 2019 is what's called a horizontal layout, and I'll show you what that all means. So for today, for the sake of this video, I'm basically going to be talking about the two different styles, two different kinds of layouts, and the pluses and the minuses for various situations, and to help you kind of figure out and work through what might be the style that works for you. And if you want to go with one of these guys, great. But if you run over to your big box store and just grab one off the shelf, you know, that's also cool. Hopefully this will help you narrow down what will work for you. Because obviously, as beautiful as something may be and as fun as it may be to use, if it doesn't help you with your own goals and getting through the day, you know, that's not right for you, right? So we're going to help you find what's right for you. We're going to try. And always, if you find something that works for you, you can put it in the comments below. Let's just keep it helpful. And I think this will be fun. Okay, so we'll get started. The past couple years, I've used the Passion Planner. I have had a lot of different things going on. I write. I still write. I have articles coming out once in a while and try to maintain my website. And it's, you know, just a lot of different things. I've got some books I'm still working on and still waiting to hear back from. And on top of that, I also have run an Etsy shop for a few years, and I'm actually winding that down. But for the past few years, I've had that open. I've done some shows with that, you know, like craft shows. And I also do temp work as I can pick it up, which is pretty normal for any writer, any published author. Unless you really hit it big time, you're pretty much doing more than just trying to write books. You've got to do other things too. So honestly, I've had a slew of things going on. So the Passion Planner has been perfect for this. Now the one I'm showing you today is just my home one. I've got a bigger one I use for the office, but I think this might be easier for you to see on camera. And again, I think some things have changed just a little bit with Passion Planner, but the gist is going to be the same. Well, this year I decided to go with the Erin Condren, because last year I had one planner for my work side of life and then one planner for my home side of life. And I found in the summer that I wasn't using the work one so much. A lot has changed in my personal life, in my goals for my work life. And honestly, the Passion Planner just is too much. But the reason that it's too much might be exactly why you might like a Passion Planner, which is why I'm going to go through both of these. So we're going to start with the Passion Planner, so you can see what it's all about. And again, this is last year's color. They do not offer it this year, but I just want to give you an idea of like what they look like. These are, they're bound. They have a nice edge as opposed to the Erin Condren. that I chose for this year, which has the spiral edge. Now I do have an Erin Condren from last year, I'll show you in a minute. It also is, it's hardbound with the same edge. So that is one difference. So if you're tactile and the spiral bothers you a little bit, just wanna point this out. That's something to keep in mind when you shop. As for the layouts, for a passion planner, I'll show you an example. This is what a weekly layout is. Y'all can see that, okay? You have your vertical columns, and let's see if I can go up here a little bit, and you can see how they're divided into half an hour time slots. You also have over here, let's see, that is, it says this week's focus. You've also got good things that happened. You've got a nice quote. You've got a space here to do whatever you want, whether it's doodle, write your own notes, or just leave it blank. And then over here you have your priorities too of work and personal life, which is really helpful. So again, this is for any given week. The monthly layout, I'll be honest, I've already filled my monthly layout, so I don't have a blank one to show you, but it's along the same lines where you're basically identifying your goals for the month and then some high-level things you need to do. I mean, the layouts itself for the month is like a basic layout you'll see in any journal, calendar, whatever, but it does have places and prompts for you to think about what your goals are, and then the week drills it down just a little bit more. I think this is really good for working on executive functioning skills because it gets you to think, what is it I need to do? What is it that I need to do for the month? What is it I need to do this specific week? And how do I accomplish that? And it kind of breaks your goals down and it helps your thought process identify what it is you need to do and how you can get there. So I cannot recommend this enough. In fact, there's some personal and professional goals of my own that I've accomplished, especially some personal ones that I just kind of thought, eh, if it happens, it happens. I can't imagine it'll happen. But by going through and really thinking about the steps needed to achieve those goals, I actually was able to do it, and it's really helped me a lot. But again, for this year, I don't need all this detail. It's too much. But for you, this might be perfect. Because again, you know, you may have appointments coming up with your therapist, various therapists, you may have school activities and all kinds of things, and you really need this drill down, this bit where you can go to the hour, the half hour, and to make sure everything fits and everything works. And you also might benefit from all these prompts too to help you really focus and see what you need. In the back of it too, let's see if I got any blank pages. They have like blanks pages you can use. I think I may have used it all. There's some graph paper. I know y'all can't really see that. It's like glary. But there's space where you can just make your own raw notes. In the beginning, there's a general planning that you can do just for the entire year, or even look, you know, 5 years out and so on. That, again, I kind of used it up so I can't show it. But go to passionplanner.com. You can see all the details and what they offer for that. Again, if you need a lot of structure in your life and you need help creating that structure, I think this is a really good choice for you and something to consider. And again, with someone, I know with our daughter, being able to really write down what she needed to do when, even when her free time was, it was good. And here's another thought with this too. A lot of times we kind of can get involved with some things, you know, say for me it's writing. If I'm working on a book and I'm going to do, say, 2 hours, and then it ends up being 4, and then everything else is kind of messed up. Well, if you want to drill down and block out, say, you know, from 1 to 3 I'm writing today, and then maybe set a timer to go along with it, then you know that this is your time to do it. You block it off and then you move on after that, and that can help too. Because I know for some of us, it might not be as much of an issue of starting on something, which, you know, it can be, but sometimes it's also when to finish it and when to stop and when to transition to the next thing. And I think that using something like this where you can see what's next will help you develop those skills. Does that make sense? Because sometimes, y'all, we have trouble with transition, right? Going from one thing to the other. But if it's written down and it's pre-planned and we know what to expect, it can make it a whole lot easier. So I think that's something to keep in mind with Asperger's in the house, you know? So if you have Asperger's, this could be something or a tool that can work for you. And yeah, so that's the thought on that. Now, Erin Condren does have different layouts you can choose. Again, the Passion Planner that we looked at is called the Vertical Layout. They do offer that in Erin Condren, and I think there's 2 different styles. I think there's like a real freeform one and then one with the times. But what I want to show with you, again, this is not so much, you know, Passion Planner versus Erin Condren, though it's going to feel that way. It's about style. So this year I didn't want all that. I didn't need all that stuff that Passion Planner has. I wouldn't be surprised if I return to it, but just for this coming year, I need to really pare down a lot of things in my life, and I need to make myself go to something a bit more simple and focus on that. With Passion Planner, the cool thing is you can do a cover, you know, as you choose, in a sense. They have tons to pick from, and you get to pick your cover. They basically snap in and out, and I'm not going to show you that because I'm afraid I'm going to kind of break the little things here. But the other thing too is, from a tactile standpoint, this is laminated. It's very smooth, a little bendy, whereas a Passion Planner has more of like a faux leathery sort of feel to it, if that makes a difference for you. Again, you know, I'm tactile, so the spiral for me is going to be taking a bit to get used to. That's kind of like what I think when I touch the spiral. When we open this up, one of the neat things, again, this is the Life Planner horizontal layout. We have a section here that you can write with a dry erase marker. You can write your notes. And in the back, we have the same thing. So if you're always changing and your to-do lists and all that, you've got a space where you can just perpetually change everything that you need doing. Some stuff I have in here is extras, and we're not going to worry about that today. But I want to basically show you, because this is brand spanking new. I just got this, y'all. What I mean by a monthly layout. So there's your monthly. So when I talk monthly, see? Okay, all right. Passion Planner is going to have some prompts for you along with this general spread. Erin Condren just has notes, but again, this is fine. You can put doctor's appointments in here. You can put school meetings in here. You can put work stuff in here. Maybe school's not even in your life right now. I know for us, you know, our daughter has already graduated college, so we've gone on to another phase of life right now. But there's space. If you don't have a ton, you can throw that in here. And that's what I was looking for. So let's turn and I'll show you what we mean by horizontal. Okay, do you see that? Okay, so the days are going this way now. All right, and then over here, can you see here? There's a block here. We can do whatever you want. And then there's some lines. Again, I'm a writer, and I'm kind of going back to wanting to do some journaling and things like that. Each week, each day, and this for me is going to be better. I've got some personal things that I want to explore, and this format for me is going to be much better for that. For some of you, this might be better too. If there's some things that you want to think about, you could use it as a gratitude journal. You could use it as you know, maybe there's something that you're working on, like a project or whatever. You can write your notes on that. Just whatever you want to do. I mean, stickers, y'all can buy stickers if you want to be, you know, really get into that side of planner life, which I'm going to try this year, but I haven't done before. So anyway, so that's basically it. There's tons of videos on Erin Condren if you want to see different things. The beautiful thing with her stuff too is, see this? There's a pouch that I got that came with this. It was like a little gift thing. And I attached a little doohickey here. I know that's not quite great English. But it snaps right into the spine. So now I have this little pouch. I can keep stickers in here and all that. And honestly, you can accessorize this sucker 10 ways from Sunday, which I think is gonna be a lot of fun. I love this kind of a thing. So I think that'll be good. Whereas the Passion Planner, when we open up and we look in here, okay, it's all bound. So anything you stick in will either have to be posted it in, glued in, or it just slipped in there. Okay, so, so that's a difference with the layouts of the two. Another thing comes down to visuals. If you're visual, the Passion Planner, depending on what color you pick, can be, you know, that can make a difference. There's the basic black, and then they have a few other colors they're offering this year, but the inside is all going to be black and white. You do have a tail here. I don't know if this is the color they stick with, this lime green, or if they'll change it, but that's about all the color you're going to have with that. With the Erin Condren, it's really up to you. There's two different styles from what I understand. One of them is basic, and it's pretty much black and white. I'm not sure, because y'all, I'm new to this, and if y'all know, let me know. When you get up here in the corners, if all that's grayed out, I think it might be on the one that's more basic. But this is considered the colorful one. And as you can see by the tabs that it comes with, you know, I didn't even have to stick these in here, which is perfect. They've done it for you. It's all, you know, each month has its own color. And for me, being very visual, this works really, really well. So if you're highly visual, you want to go by color, this is awesome. The funny thing is, if you have synesthesia, which like I do, which is basically like you can see words and letters and colors and things like that, and your numbers have colors to them, and there's more to it, but that's just a high level example. like to you, January might be like purple, and now January is teal. And I know it sounds goofy, but if you've got synesthesia, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So if that's gonna trip you up, y'all, just keep that in mind as you look at this. But yeah, I think this is really nice. It's a really nice layout, and I think for what I need, it's gonna be good. And I wanna give you a tip. If you have some personal things that you're working on, like so for parents, y'all, I know we can look at the gaps a lot of the time. In fact, my husband pointed out to me last year that I tend to kind of find the gaps in things, and I was like, oh crud. I was really glad he actually pointed that out to me, because I did not realize that. And it's something that I'm working on. I'm going to try to get better at, you know, not doing, if you will. You could use this, if you use a horizontal style, to say something about your family that you appreciate, something about the day that you appreciate, and really try to write down the victories and the good things that happen and the growth that happens. Because I think it's really important that we don't treat our kids like projects, because I think sometimes we treat our kids like projects. And that's not good for anybody, is it? No, let's give them the freedom to be who they are. Okay, now, I did say I was gonna show you this one. This is last year's. They don't offer this particular color design this year, but they do offer this style. This is horizontal. This is a smaller one. So if you want a smaller one with the spine, you will still get the month view. But when you go to the weekly view, instead of having that little box that was here, you just get the one section here. But the nice thing too with Erin Condren, if you go colorful, is like say this was June. All right, it's green. We get to July, we change to like this dark pink, this magenta. So you can visually see when the month is going to change. And I think those visual cues can also be really helpful. But yeah, I know, you see, I didn't write in that month because the first half of the year, I wasn't sure what I was gonna do with this. And then the last half of the year after everything had changed and whatever, I found that I started using this quite a bit. So again, these are just different options for you. From a size standpoint, Passion Planner is changing. Again, where they offer to just one size. Last year they had a couple. So I don't have one to show you for this year. If you can get an idea of the size for Erin Condren for the Life Planner, this is how big it is. It's nice. To me, when I looked online at different YouTubers, it looked bigger. For some reason, I don't know why, but I love the size. It's very manageable, and I'm very happy with it. And again, compared to the hardbound, the small one, there's that. Again, Erin Condren has tons of kinds, so if you like that style better, go to the website, check it out, and take a look around. But again, horizontal versus vertical is going to be one of your main choices when it comes to planner. Questions to ask yourself. Do you need a planner that's going to have time slots for you to fill out, that is going to help you navigate your day, navigate your week, navigate your month? Another benefit with Passion Planner that I found is, see in the back, you have a monthly reflection. And it's going to ask you questions about your goals, how did your month go, and you get to reassess, and this can be really helpful for some people. Erin Condren has some stuff too to help you. It's just very, very different. A little bit of a different focus. So those are just some things to consider. Okay, this video got to be a bit longer than I was expecting, but I hope it's helped. I mean, we can talk about planners for a long time. There's just so many different styles and kinds and types. So I guess I'll leave with some questions to ask yourself. One is, what kind of scheduling do you need in your life? Think about that, because you want a planner. If you're a highly detailed person who needs that structure, you want a planner that's going to break things down hour by hour, half hour by half hour, or whatever it is to help you out. If you're more free-flowing, or you want to use it more just for your high-level events like appointments and things like that, you might find the horizontal works well, because you can use that section for other things, you know, for other things that are important to you. So if you have any questions, let me know. Put that in the comment below. If this has been helpful, if you can click the like button, that would be great. And I'll try to put a link to the other video for you that shows you why I switched from Passion to Erin Condren, if you want to check that out. Kind of covered it here a little bit. But yeah, I guess that's it. All right. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope y'all are doing great, and have a great day. Bye, y'all.